भाई मुझे इसके बाद कोई मुझसे कोई सवाल पूछता है तो मैं जवाब देता हूँ। बहुत मजा आया अपने बारे में बात करके, तो हमेशा ही मजा आता है। इट्स एब्सोल्युटली फैंटास्टिक, नॉट जस्ट वर्ल्ड सिनेमा, द वे इट्स एक्सपेंडिंग एंड मेकिंग क्रिएटिंग एन अवेयरनेस अबाउट एबैंडन्ड एनिमल्स, अबाउट अदर फॉर्म्स ऑफ आर्ट, अबाउट राइटिंग, लिटरेचर, थिएटर, एवरीथिंग इज एब्सोल्युटली वंडरफुल एंड ऑल स्ट्रेंथ टू ओशियानामा। आई होप टू बी कनेक्टेड विद ओशियानामा फॉरएवर।
When he was alive, I have to say that he and I didn't care for each other. We had no time for each other. We had nothing to say to each other. And I don't know where this happened along the way, because I was the youngest, and the youngest is always the most pampered. So I was, I'm told. I can recall things from very early childhood as well. And then somewhere along the way the relationship went sour. It could be something to do with my academic achievements, because in kindergarten, in class 1, two, right up to class 3 or 4, I was among the best students. And then it started plummeting. And the nadir came when I stood 50th in a class of 50. In class 9, he was deeply disappointed. He could not imagine a life beyond the conventional choices for any of his children. He would have dearly loved me to be a doctor, and I told him that I can't study those fat books for 5 years. When I decided to do a drama course for 3 years and a film course for 2 years after that, he said, "You want to study this bloody acting for 5 years? Might as well study medicine." He could not comprehend at all what I was, where I was coming from. I've ever been as terrified of anyone ever in my life as I was of him. And the funny thing is, he never was physically brutal. He never hit any of us. But just that look from above his reading glasses was enough to freeze one's blood. So I used to crib and confide in my mom, who also didn't understand. He tried his best to do whatever he could to make me toe the line. And that's an important lesson I've learned when dealing with my own children. That you've got to love them enough to let them go. They're going to do what they're going to do. I did what I had to do, and he tried everything in his power to make me do what he wished. My natural feeling of rebellion against authority, my natural dislike, awe, I don't know what it is, fear, it's a whole lot of things that drove me to this. I don't think anyone can define where the influences come from. I don't think a writer can define that. I don't think a painter can define it. I don't think an actor or a dancer can define it. There are certainly influences which have happened by osmosis over the years. But the different point. I do know that while playing the part in Gandhi, which was about Gandhi and his son, I could look at both points of view quite objectively. I could see what my dad was about, and I could see what my children were about. Because my son asked me, in fact, "Hey, Baba, what would you do if you were faced with a dilemma like he was faced, where he wanted to send, he was asked to send the brightest pupil to become a barrister abroad. And his son was hoping he would be sent, but he wasn't. He chose another boy who he thought was brighter. I think my father would have done that. I don't think I would. I think I made the same blunders with you as my father. Worse, perhaps, blunders than my father made with me. I just ignored her completely. I was not fond of children. I mean, I don't think any 19, 20-year-old is. They're messy and they're noisy. No, I'm sure they did, but I can't specify in where.
So then let's move to, one thing I noticed is that your father, someone like Jeffrey Kendall, then someone like Al-Khazi, then someone like Taneja, who was your acting teacher at FTII, that obviously Om was one of your colleagues and also an inspiration, and then Shah. You've got these Dubey and Satyadev Dubey. You've got these very amazing personalities who entered your life at different stages.
Yeah, all surrogate fathers.
Yes. So if you could go one by one, obviously someone like Jeffrey Kendall, his passion, his dedication, taking Shakespeare to India, like, and you wrote a line about, that's what I really wish to do, be this man dancing on the other side of life, carefree, exactly on my terms, and sharing it with the world. That was a great inspiration for you?
Yeah, looking back on it, that memory is something which is almost transcendental, because it's difficult to believe, but I do have this very, very distinct memory of this man on a platform which seemed as high as the sky, with this garishly painted face and these incredibly hypnotic eyes, who was dancing on that platform, and I was completely hypnotized. And I still remember the feeling that ran through my body when I looked at this man. It's a memory that stayed with me. I don't know what part it's played, again, but certainly it has. And to go a little further into your question, I'll do something very interesting and funny. When I say that you don't know where the influences come from, I was playing beautiful, and you know, you remind me so much of your mother, she said. And this Mad Magazine type of humor that it had, and the fact that I think it was made with genuine feeling, I can testify to that. It was hell making that movie, because we had very little money and very few resources. I believed in Kundan because he's one of the very, very few, very, 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 very few Film Institute direction students whose diploma films I didn't get a headache watching. Kundan made this thing called Bonga, which was quite insane. It was a comedy. Nobody in the Film Institute made their diploma film as a comedy. They all made statements of cosmic importance. They had to show all their abilities in their first movie. They had to prove that they are Fellini and Kurosawa and Godard combined.
बहुत कमाल का एक्सपीरियंस रहा, और इतना ट्रांसपेरेंसी से बोलते हैं वो, इतना ऑनेस्टी से, कि बहुत सारे डाउट्स बहुत सारे न्यू कमर्स के, एक्टर्स के, राइटर्स के, किस तरह से क्लियर हुए होंगे आज, मैं उसको महसूस कर सकता हूँ. बहुत सारी चीज़ें हम लोग काम करते हैं तो सोचते रहते हैं, वो प्रोसेस ऐसी चलती रहती है कि दिमाग में बहुत सारे सवाल खड़े हो जाते हैं ना आपके. और कई बार पहले भी अपने इंटरव्यू में नसी साहब बोल चुके हैं कि बहुत अच्छे एक्टिंग टीचर्स हैं नहीं हमारे हिंदुस्तान में, तो वो जो सवाल एक्टर्स के जहन में घूमते रहते हैं वो उससे उलझते रहते हैं. यहाँ आज बहुत सारा जो उन्होंने कहा उस बारे में, उससे बहुत सारी चीज़ें क्लियर हो जाती हैं. तो बहुत ही कमाल का ये सेशन हुआ. जिस चीज़ से आप नहीं सेटिस्फाइड हैं या जिस चीज़ को आप जिसमें कंफर्टेबल नहीं हैं उसको एक्सेप्ट कर रहे हैं खुल के, ये बहुत ही सेटिस्फाइड एक्टर ही कर सकता है. जो कहते हैं ना जिसने पा लिया है अपने आप को, और नसीर साहब ने तो पा ही लिया है, खैर उस बारे में क्या कहें हम. तो मुझे नहीं लगता कि उनको किसी बात का टेंशन है या वो ये सोचते होंगे. ये यंग एक्टर्स शायद हम और आप सोच सकते हैं, लेकिन उनकी स्टेज में वो बहुत सही कर रहे हैं और मैं उसको अप्रिशिएट करता हूँ. ठीक है, करते हैं, बोलते हैं तो बोलते हैं, अच्छा है, और उससे सीखने को भी मिलता है हम लोगों को. टाइम होता भी है तो हम थोड़े से लापरवाह हो जाते हैं. तो आज की क्लास में मुझे लगा कि अब मैं थोड़ा और डिटरमिन हो जाऊँगा उसको लेकर.
नहीं, इट वॉज अ वेरी गुड एक्सपीरियंस फॉर द क्राउड. द क्राउड वॉज यंग एंड लॉट ऑफ आर्ट स्टूडेंट्स एंड सिनेमा स्टूडेंट्स एंड मीडिया स्टूडेंट्स वर देयर. एंड नसीर साहब स्पोक वेरी वेल, एंड ही इवन स्पोक ऑन द कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल क्वेश्चन ऑफ हिज लाइफ, इंक्लूडिंग हिज इनिशियल स्ट्रगल डेज एंड सम रीसेंट कॉन्ट्रोवर्सीज विच हैपेंड. बट आई थिंक ही वॉज वेरी वेरी ऑनेस्ट इन हिज आंसर्स, एंड ही वॉज वेरी इम्प्रेसिव. ही कंडक्टेड इट वेरी वेल. Of course, Mr. Tulip posed some very intelligent questions, but he was, I think, equally intelligent in his answers and very honest. So it was a very rare chance, and I think it being his first masterclass, he did exceptionally well.
What's next in Kushi Nama Yoga Discipline after this masterclass?
Wait and watch. We are planning some very big events, and each event will be unique in itself. And I don't want to disclose anything as of now.